Theresa May has been forced to abandon plans for an emergency cabinet meeting to approve a Brexit deal, after fresh opposition at home and abroad plunged her timetable into turmoil. The Prime Minister shelved the meeting, penciled in for Monday, slamming on the brakes after fierce resistance in her cabinet and in Brussels threatened to derail the path to an agreement. A government source conceded that an outline deal might not be ready by Tuesday, making it increasingly unlikely that a special EU summit to sign it off can be held in November, as hoped. That would leave the UK having to ramp up hugely expensive no-deal preparations and in danger of being unable to pass all necessary legislation before the Brexit deadline next March. At home, Ms. May faced an open challenge to her plans from Andrea Leadsom, the Commons leader, who vowed the UK cannot be held against its will by the backstop plan for the Irish border. Ms. Leadsom became the second cabinet minister to insist on a unilateral power to escape being bound in the EU customs union, something explicitly ruled out by Brussels. In the Belgian capital, talks between UK and EU officials hit a wall over how to terminate the backstop, with fishing rights another key obstacle. Meanwhile, there was fresh confusion over Labour's stance on a final say referendum on the Brexit outcome, with Emily Thornberry, the shadow foreign secretary, directly contradicting Jeremy Corbyn. Cabinet ministers had been told to clear their diaries for an approve the deal meeting at the end of last week, a get-together then put back until Monday. But, the source told The Independent, there is not going to be one tomorrow. They added, the cabinet will meet as normal on Tuesday, but I can't say if it going to be a Brexit cabinet or not, because the negotiations are ongoing, created with sketch. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London the 20th of October 2018. Protesters wearing Final Say shirts and holding placards red smoke from a canister hangs in the air as around 100,000 demonstrators march through London during a People's Vote anti-Brexit demonstration. Savings banners and placards anti-Brexit People's Vote March for the Future in London. Mayor of London Sadiq Khan takes part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. MP Chuka Amuna, left, and MP Vince Cable, right, as MP Anna Soubry, centre, addresses anti-Brexit campaigners at a rally after the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators with banners were with EU during the People's Vote March for the Future in London, Britain, the 20th of October 2018. Reports state that the March for the Future is to be led by a column of young people and call for a People A Circumflex Euro-S vote on the Brexit deal. After marching through central London, there will be a rally on stage in Parliament Square, including speeches from Mayor of London Sadiq Khan. Editor of The Independent Christian Brown speaks to demonstrators in Parliament Square after they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London the 20th of October 2018. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators hold placards as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London the 20th of October 2018. Campaigner wrapped an EU flag. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London the 20th of October 2018. Demonstrators passed Trafalgar Square as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Demonstrators wave union and European flags and hold up placards as they pass Trafalgar Square, taking part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Demonstrators hold placards as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. A demonstrator holds a message during a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators take part in the People's Vote March for the Future, in central London, Britain, the 20th of October 2018. Reports state that the March for the Future is to be led by a column of young people and call for a people a circumflex Euro-S vote on the Brexit deal. After marching through central London, there will be a rally on stage in Parliament Square, including speeches from Mayor of London Sadiq Khan. A protester brandishes an independent T-shirt during the Brexit march anti-Brexit campaigners take part in. The People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Tens of thousands of people take part in People's Vote March for the Future in central London. The march organised by the People's Vote campaign is led by young people calling for a people's vote on the Brexit deal. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, the 20th of October 2018. Protesters wearing Final Say shirts and holding placards. Red smoke from a canister hangs in the air as around 100,000 demonstrators march through London during a People's Vote anti-Brexit demonstration. Savings banners and placards. Anti-Brexit People's Vote March for the Future in London. Mayor of London Sadiq Khan takes part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. MP Chuka Amuna, left, and MP Vince Cable, right, as MP Anna Soubry, centre, addresses anti-Brexit campaigners at a rally after the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators with banners were with EU during the People's Vote March for the Future in London, Britain, the 20th of October 2018. Reports state that the March for the Future is to be led by a column of young people and call for a people a circumflex Euro-S vote on the Brexit deal. After marching through central London, there will be a rally on stage in Parliament Square, including speeches from Mayor of London Sadiq Khan. Editor of The Independent Christian Brown speaks to demonstrators in Parliament Square after they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, the 20th of October 2018. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators hold placards as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, the 20th of October 2018. Campaigner wrapped an EU flag. Final say campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, the 20th of October 2018 demonstrators passed Trafalgar Square as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Demonstrators wave Union and European flags and hold up placards as they pass Trafalgar Square, taking part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Demonstrators hold placards as they take part in a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Demonstrator holds a message during a march calling for a people's vote on the final Brexit deal, in central London on October 20, 2018. Britons dreading life outside Europe gathered from all corners of the UK to London on Saturday to try to stop their country's looming breakup with the EU. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Demonstrators take part in the People's Vote March for the Future, in central London, Britain, the 20th of October 2018. Reports state that the March for the Future is to be led by a column of young people and call for a People's Circumflex Euro-S vote on the Brexit deal. After marching through central London, there will be a rally on stage in Parliament Square, including speeches from Mayor of London Sadiq Khan. A protester brandishes an independent T-shirt during the Brexit march anti-Brexit campaigners take part in. The People's Vote March for the Future in London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. Tens of thousands of people take part in People's Vote March for the Future in central London. The march organised by the People's Vote campaign is led by young people calling for a people's vote on the Brexit deal. Anti-Brexit campaigners take part in the People's Vote March for the Future. In London, a march and rally in support of a second EU referendum. The source acknowledged the delay, but said, "The fact is that we have got to get something that's right. We are not going to accept an outline deal at all costs, and we are still working on it." Ministers are also demanding to see full legal advice on the power to be conceded over ending the backstop, after Ms. May indicated only a legal summary would be made available. The continued turmoil burst out into the open when Ms. Leadsom told BBC Radio 5 Live the UK cannot be held against its will in a customs arrangement. The Prime Minister has urged her cabinet to abandon hopes of a unilateral power to end the backstop and push for a joint review mechanism with Brussels instead. But pro-Brexit Tories fear the UK will lock indefinitely into the customs union, unable to sign its own trade deals, unless it can end the backstop unilaterally, at some point soon after 2020. Ms. Leadsom said, "It must be capable for the United Kingdom to decide to leave that customs arrangement, and it cannot be something that the European Union can then hold us to." And she warned, "It's because that would be to then fail to fulfill on the will of the people expressed in the referendum, and I very much doubt that we would get it through Parliament." The warning came days after Liam Fox, the International Trade Secretary, also insisted the power must rest with the sovereign British government. Ms. Leadsom also rejected the idea of an independent body to review if an alternative solution has been found to avoid checks at the Irish border, something dependent on untested technology. However, she insisted she was not on the verge of resigning, saying, "I'm sticking in the government to make sure that's where we get to in the end." Crucially, the EU is believed to have rejected Britain's proposal of independent arbitration over ending the backstop, insisting the European Court of Justice must make the decision. If the Prime Minister also makes that concession, after repeatedly ruling out ECJ jurisdiction, she would risk even greater opposition on the Tory benches. Ms. Thornberry sought to calm Labour tensions by saying the party could still back a final say Brexit referendum, just a day after her leader rubbished the idea. The shadow foreign secretary said, all options remain on the table, if Labour fails to force a general election by voting against the deal, if there is one. Mr. Corbyn has angered Labour MPs and supporters by arguing Brexit cannot be stopped, and by going on to reject the growing calls for a fresh public vote. But Ms. Thornberry said, if we don't have a general election then, yes, of course all the options remain on the table and we would campaign for there to be a people's vote, but there are several stages before we get that. The Independent has launched its Sign Our Petition here.